How's it going, everybody? It's your boy, Yamsy Boy, and we are here for day 11 of Octopath Traveler. Last time, we got our butts handed to us by a couple of advanced job bosses, but we also got through one or two fourth character chapters, namely Ophelia's, so we were able to swap her out of the party at long last. I like having her, but at the same time, I think there might be better party compositions that don't include her, and having her forced kind of felt like it might have been holding me back a little bit. Not that I'm optimal at the moment or anything, but that's neither here nor there. Goal of today is to do more chapter 4's, and I'm outside of the Shrine of the Archmages right now, which is where the Sorcerer advanced job is, and I'm going to try my hand at that and see how well it works out for me. I'm going to try and not get in battles. He's not doing that right now. Evasive maneuvers will help. Excuse me. One thing, I have him as a merchant right now. I'm working towards SP saver, but don't have it yet. Saving grace will be helpful. Persistence will be nice. I think I'll replace evasive maneuvers with that once I actually get to the boss, but I want to get in as few encounters as possible. Do you have saving grace? Yes, okay. Being able to overheal will always be super helpful. Alright, in we go. What could go wrong? Well, based on the other dungeons I've been in, a lot could go wrong. Not sure where I'm going, but I'm going there. Those are treasure chests. While I was off stream, I think I already looted this whole place, so I don't have to worry about that. But I don't remember where the boss was located. Thankfully, these enemies are actually really easy. Ow! They do hurt, though. Unfortunately, she can't hit anything. So, just heal. I did make her a competent healer, though. Like, I buffed up her elemental defense, like, as high as I could with the equipment I had on hand. There's not really much he needs to do right now, so I guess I'll just steal some SP. Nice miss. Very cool. Wait, why was that guy still able to act? He's broken. Or was that the one I didn't break, buffing his buddy? Fine, I guess that makes sense. Maybe I go left? Well, that sure ain't it. down just leads to a treasure chest as well. Looks like I went the right way after all. And he's dead. That was fast. Need to hit the knight dude a bit more, but Therian can't do anything to hit him. Focus on the knight, at least until the shield points even out a bit more. Let's see. Luminescence will help. Don't die! With that, I will be able to break. Let me get some heals out. Get out of here. Irritating group of enemies. Okay, here we are. I just didn't go left far enough. Get my skills set up for boss battles. Too bad I don't have SP Saver, but Inner Strength. It's kinda close. And he doesn't have heightened healing either. Well, just gotta hope he doesn't die so much. Alright, dudes, here we go. This is gonna be painful. But hopefully not quite as painful as Starseer. Hello? Okay, let's go.
Do it.
What's the worst that could happen?
I'm already afraid.
Weak to electric, alright.
Alright. Let's start testing things out. That lowers my attack stats and prevents me from buffing myself. That's gross. So I can't even get rid of the lowered attack stats. Oof. No me gusta. Stab? Stab. Okay. Oh, right. With that debuff, there's no point in actually doing this, is there? That's unfortunate. I shouldn't have attacked with Therion. I should have just lowered his defense to get ready for breaking him. Oh well. Probably not going to deal much damage, but every little bit, I guess. This seems manageable so far. Let's see. I don't want to break him just yet. Do I? No, because Ulrich goes before Therion next turn, somehow. Ulrich with his, like, 50 speed compared to Therion's 550. That works. Probably worth. The first hit's not going to deal full damage, but I can donate BP to him with Tressa. Oh, this is going to be a while. Get stabbed? Oh, right, I boosted last turn with Tressa. She's not going to be able to donate more than one. Okay. Well, I can use energizing plums, I guess. I got plenty. Or pomegranates. You can collect from this moss? Huh. And if only I could augment all allies in elemental defense, that would be great. This isn't gonna be amazing, because debuff, but it's the best I can do. It's like half the damage I normally deal. It feels so bad. Okay.
just get those overheal shields up. So you got wind, okay. Ooh, he gets light spells. That's neat. I wonder if he gets all elements. That would be pretty awesome. Better him than anyone else, I guess. That's actually not too bad. Alright, let me look at my setup I got going on right now. What can I do with the turns I have leading up into the next turn? I could buff Ulbrich. And then Cyrus's turn, I could break him this turn. Although I think it'd be better to break him next turn. I can get him ready to be broken. Okay, for this, I plan out my actions carefully. Maybe I shouldn't have had my thief and dancer be the same person. I had another way to raise someone else's elemental attack besides Peacock's Root. But it is what it is. I should have made, like, Tressa the dancer or something. I'm afraid of what he might do if I give him his turn right now. He might just ruin everything. Like, I don't know, debuff everybody? Okay, that's fine. I'm fine with this. Hey, get reflected, bitch. I'll just keep her on full-time support. This should hurt. Well, it would have. If he could break the damage cap. I don't think I have enough JP to put him in Warrior and do that, though. Not yet. Oh, well. Ah, that, however, as satisfying as ever. Axes? Nope. Knife? Nope. Bow? Yes. Stick? No. And that's what I was afraid he was gonna do if I gave him that turn before I broke him, but thankfully he didn't. But now he did, and that's irritating. It's probably gonna be probably best if I just wait for it to wear off. Just give yourself some SP, alright? You're kinda useless right now. What do? I don't know if I dare. If I'm being perfectly honest. Fire? That means the last one has to be dark. Hey! Fucking rude. Eh, just throw a thing. I'm just gonna play it safe and keep shields up on everybody as much as I can. It could be more aggressive, but I get the feeling this battle is gonna be kind of slow and steady might win the race. Hopefully. Oh, right, he reduced our elemental defense. That makes sense. I was about to say, where the fuck did that damage come from? And thanks to that annoying debuff we have on, we can't even get rid of that debuff if we wanted to. Yikes. Okay. What can I do to fight this? Ailments haven't been the problem. It's been debuffs. I don't think I have any accessories that defend against debuffs, unfortunately. What about skills? That's ailments. That's also ailments. Shit. There's not much I can do against that. Thanks to the stupid debuffs that prevent me from getting rid of debuffs. Oh, I do have surpassing power. How'd you get rid of something? But that'll definitely help me deal more damage. I wonder how useful Hang Tough is against multi-hit skills. Does it still activate even if you're still being hit, or does it only activate on the first hit that brings you low? Because if it's that one, then it's going to be kind of useless in this fight. That might be the one to get rid of.
What's that? The wind!
Oh my god. This fucking bots, man. I could try different class setup or job setup. If I shift my DPS focus to Ulbrich and Therion, I could make Cyrus more of a support. Could maybe make him the dancer. That gives him 10 speed. Every little bit of speed would help. So I may not actually use the hunter part of this, but it gives me a bit of stats, so why not? And a bit of weapon coverage. Alright. Buffer elemental defense a bit more. Since I can overheal, the lower max HP isn't as big of a deal. That's my reasoning anyway. Suppose I have any armor that increases speed, do I? No. Oh, that's evasion, not speed. Wind attire increases it by a little bit, but oh my god, it's really not worth equipping, because look at those stats. No thanks. Okay. Guess that's fine. Okay, that looks a bit better. Let's see how it goes. I'll give this boss 3 tries before I move on to doing Chapter 4's. Let's see. Here come the debuffs. God, I hate it. It just freaking neuters me, and I hate it. It's so bad. If characters are at max, do they still get overhealed? Yes. It's only when they're overhealed that you can't overheal them further. Got it. Just to double check. This won't do anything, right? Right. Love it. It's the best. I guess I can look at this as a positive. I can save up my BP. Two more turns until I can start buffing. Jeez. I'm surprised I was able to take him out. What the fuck? Hey! I need that to kill you! Oh my god, are you serious? Fuck. Well, there goes all my planning. Can't boost. Okay, I don't even know how I want to approach this now. He's just completely fucked up my plan, 100%. The only thing I can really think of is let him recover, and then whittle him down and try again next opportunity. order the turns next turn. Cyrus is first. I wonder if Lion Dance helps at all with Therion's ultimate skill. Probably not. I'd probably want to do the speed dance, but I haven't learned that yet. So I tell you what, I'll boost my own elemental. You know, why did I even boost anything? Also a valid question. I didn't realize, like, my other debuff fell off, but not the one that prevents you from buffing. Shit. If only I had a skill for reducing enemy elemental attack, that'd be lovely. God damn it! I was like, don't you fucking kill Theory? Oh, damn it. He did it. What now? Let's have a look at the situation. No matter what, Therion's not going to be able to contribute to the break phase. Thanks to that guy. Appreciate ya. So, what do I do with the other three? I think the best move is going to be... This turn order sucks. I hate it. Abide. And then I have to break him with trade winds, otherwise I'll take too much damage. Okay, now I have two options here. I can Peacock Dance to boost my magic, or I could revive Therion on the hopes that he would go first next turn and use Armor Corrosive. It's not... That course of action isn't really reliable. Actually, would Peacock Dance be better than just attacking here? I don't think so, actually. Okay. Now, I do want to get Therion up, but at the same time, he gets two turns, he gets two actions at the start of next turn. So, I'm definitely going to want to get those heal shields up. Let's see, in this arrangement, it's bow, light, and dark, I believe. Cyrus is in danger of dying. Oh yeah, by the way, if you hear any chatter or bumping around in the background, we're babysitting my brother's kids. So that's what any weird noise is probably going to be. Although it should be getting close to their bedtime. Debuffs. Although I really think I shouldn't worry too much about the debuffs. I should just deal with them rather than wait them out. I learned that the hard way. Deal with dealing less damage after right break, as much as it sucks. Hey, please don't do that. I need that to do things. Okay. I'm on the cusp of breaking him. I'm not going to be able to buff myself, but I can debuff him. So what I think might be a good idea is giving energizing pomegranates to your boy Therion. Then I think I'll go ahead and break him. Use Armor Corrosive with Therion, then Ulbrich's ult. Can't buff, so no need to worry about that. Just do what I can. And I guess just a weak energizing pomegranate on Ulbrich so he can do it again next turn. Nice. It's actually comparable to Ulbrich's power. I don't really think there's any need for her to contribute to damage here. I think I want to keep her options open for support. Alright, what are you weak to, buddy? It's not axes. Knife, okay. I got a couple people that can take advantage of that. Nice. I'm guessing the middle one's either going... Oh, he just boosted his magic attack and lowered my magic defense. Oh, I don't like this. I don't like this at all. Is there anything I can do to address this? Don't think that there are any useful items to do that. Nah. Okay. I don't think there's anything I can do to prevent this from hurting like a bitch. Might be best just to defend. Reduce the damage as much as possible. Live through it, guys. Jesus Christ. Well, not a whole lot I could do about that. Oh, that's bad. I'm dead. Yep. Okay, that's attempt number two. One more loss, and I'll give it up for now and go do story stuff, but I really want this job. Not sure how to address when he buffs his magic attack and debuffs everyone's magic defense. Actually, wait, before I fight him, let me see if I can get anything that would be helpful. With the JP I currently have. Really? Dancer can buff everything except for magic defense. Great. That's kind of the one thing I need. Okay. Lick Hold Trap could be helpful for manipulating the... manipulating turn order. Aside from that, not a whole lot. Still, definitely worth getting that. I guess this is better than nothing. Okay. Did he get anything useful from the hunter? Not really. Increasing speed's probably better than getting a bit more money at the end of battle. What do you think? Everything else seems pretty good. Shoguzan will be better, since I'm swapping my DPS strategy over to physical attacking. It's better that buffs he gives out last longer than buffs he receives. Alright, third and final try. Didn't even come close the other times, but you never know. Can't buff right now. There's nothing I can do to stop this first break from just sucking, thanks to the debuffs. Get those shields up. Feels bad. Oh, we got some damage out at least. Okay. I probably should have used Abide instead, but too late now. Should be able to survive another one. Not Therian, though, no. I just noticed. Fuck! Well, there goes my idea. I'm actually not going to burn an EDT. Cybus and Therian aren't going to get any benefit out of it, so we may as well make it weaker. Have to do it. I would have liked to debuff his defense again, but I could not risk him attacking again. What kind of damage are we going to see? Oh, I wish his defense was debuffed right now. It would be glorious. Still really nice, though. Now, the other times I tried to kind of slowly build up my defenses against him, but I think the play here might actually be to break him as fast as possible. Just to prevent him from taking advantage of, you know, the bullshit magic attack debuff and magic defense, magic attack buff and magic defense debuffs that just turns into party wipes. Weaknesses right now are bow, light, and dark. I do remember that. Going to be suboptimal again, but might be worth it to just do it. No. Wait. I didn't calculate this out properly. I can't do my ult. Fuck. Well, Ulbrich can do his, so I can at least... Armor corrosive. Never mind. He doesn't. He needs two. Two SP. Good. Well. What should I do? I think I should just save my BP here. should I do instead, though? Now he's weak to what? Daggers, ice. I forget what else. I don't know if I ever figured out what else he was weak to. I think I was gonna say probably either stabs or fire. Let's try fire. Fire! This blows. What can he do? I guess he can get off some chip damage. Oh, right, I cast a buff. Damn, I keep forgetting about this. Alright, what you gonna do? I wish I had a sword move that hit multiple times. That would be cool. I could go ahead and break him. Which generally seems to be the safer option. I don't know, though. Looking at everybody's health, I think getting shields up would be a good idea. Irritating, but not that bad. Can corrode him. I'm gonna go ahead and break him as well. Unfortunately, Cyrus goes at the end of next turn. That sucks. Oh well. Would have been awesome if he went first, so I could boost either Ulbrich or Therion, but that's not in the cards. Oh my god, we're at yellow health, though. Actually, we're making progress? No problem. I am very afraid. But if his action is coming right up next, there's nothing I can do to stop it. That wasn't as bad as it could have been. It still hurt. I'm just gonna break him. Just do it. I cannot risk not giving myself a chance to breathe. Okay. I'm gonna give Energizing Pomegranate to Therion. And then they should both be able to use their ultimate move while Tressa heals up. Come on. He's gotta be close.